the Nutra Medical Report, and we're joined all the way from Tomorrow with Jonathan Gray in New Zealand. Welcome back, Jonathan. Welcome back, Jonathan. Hello, Jonathan. Are you there? Hello, Jonathan Gray in New Zealand. I can hear an echo there.
Hello, Dr. Bill. Good to hear you.
I guess. Can you turn him up if you can? Osman on the board. There we go. Jonathan, yeah, welcome back. I guess we had a few little glitches getting you connected. We need to get you connected more often. That way we can be really good at it, connecting all the way to tomorrow. Tell us about this latest this latest book, The Ark Conspiracy. Tell us all about this, because you write some of the most fascinating books and you reference them to actual ancient archaeology. And that's what people need to do as a believer, as a scientist, as a person asking tough questions. They need to look more clearly at the nature of what our universe is and what's really going on. Let's talk about this book, The Ark Conspiracy.
Yes, the Ark Conspiracy, Dr. Bill, is about the strange goings-on in Turkey in the mountains of Ararat, when a massive boat-shaped thing popped up out of the ground, and it provoked rather a deadly game of betrayals and break-ins, murder attempts, and wonderful miracles. It's been really a high-class drama. And we've had our teams going out there, getting right into the middle of it.
So this is something that could have been made into a Indiana Jones-style blockbuster, but it's based on reality. Can you tell us about some of the details of what happened?
Yes, certainly. Back in 1970, Life magazine published an aerial photograph of a boat-shaped object in the mountains of eastern Turkey. And this had been photographed by NATO pilots who were actually at the time involved in the Cold War with Russia, and they were worried about Russian missiles being positioned in that area facing west. So they photographed the mountains periodically, and they came up with tens of thousands of photographs, and these were examined by Dr. Brandenberger in Ohio State University in the USA. And one of them popped up and he said, "Hey, this is a boat. It can't be anything else." Now, this guy is a world expert on photogrammetry, which is three-dimensional photographing. And this, of course, launched an expedition. That's how it got started.
Yes. So tell us more about what happened after that.
Well, a team went there in the next year, and they examined the thing. It was in the ground. It was just the outline of it was sticking up above the ground. Everything else was buried. And they thought, well, this might just be a freak of nature. So one bright spark on the team said, "Well, why don't we blast a hole in the side and see if anything comes out? Shall we call that good archaeological practice?"
I don't think so.
So they did that, and out came some petrified wood. But because they didn't think, I mean, if this was an ark or a boat, they thought, well, wood does not petrify so easily or so quickly, so this cannot be man-made. It would have to be natural. And nobody did anything for about, almost 20 years. And then an American archaeologist from Nashville, Tennessee, went across with his two sons to examine it, and he saw things that they had not seen. So he came back. He got a group of Christian friends together. He said, "Look, if this is significant, we need to pray that God will do something and he'll lift this thing out of the ground. It's too big to excavate. It's 1.5 times longer than a football field."
Yeah, it's much bigger than...
And so they got to praying.
Right. Well, who's the name of this gentleman?
I'm a great believer in prayer. I've seen marvelous things happen.
Right. Who's the name of this gentleman, Dr. Gray?
Yes.
Who's the name of the gentleman, the Christian...
His name was Ronald Wyatt.
Ah, I've heard of Ronald Wyatt. In fact, I've known Ronald, and I think he's had his story out for a long time. He has some kind of an ARC institute down in, I believe, in Tennessee, isn't it?
That's right. Yes, he has.
Yeah, that's amazing.
It used to be a service station, a petrol station. Now it's been turned into quite a nice museum.
Wow. Please continue.
And do you know what happened just a few months after they began their regular prayer session? An earthquake took place. But first, something interesting happened. The sky turned silver. The whole sky in that part of Turkey turned absolutely silver, like silver paper. And this was so unusual that the whole population just came out of their houses. The truck drivers stopped their trucks in the middle of the road. Children were taken out of school, and they were all looking up at this silver sky. And when everybody was safely out of their houses, where they were out of danger if an earthquake came, suddenly a big earthquake came, and it lifted this boat-shaped thing 20 feet out of the ground.
Wow. What year is this now?
The man that owned the field said, hey, this has come up, it's ruined my field.
Oh, my gosh.
Meant now that something had happened, something that had been prayed for several months.
Wow, that is amazing. Now, what year was this roughly?
This was 1960.
1960. So over these many years since then, what's transpired? Because I'm sure that this is a remarkable, it should be a mini-series documentary on this. What's happened?
I'm sorry, 1960, I mean 1970, sorry.
1970, yeah. So what's happened since 1970? I'd heard that there were tons of actual ground-penetrating radar and other proof that this does exist. And
yes.
It's amazing that the regular media is not covering it at all.
That's right. Well, what happened after that was that some guys went back there. They were able to take... in fact, 34 expeditions have gone over this. I've taken quite a few myself with scientists. And the overall picture is this, that first of all, metal detector tests were made, and a whole pattern of metal at regular intervals was found within this boat shape. In fact, there were 4,300 metal rivets identified, rivets which were holding cross pieces together. Then radar was brought in, and the radar showed that there were cavities at regular intervals. In other words, there's a pattern to them, not just holes in the ground underneath, but a pattern of regular, with a passageway going down the middle. And part of the side was scraped off. And underneath that were found to be upright ribs, as it were, ribs like a boat. And crossing those like a lattice pattern horizontally were more of these. And that was just the beginning, but these were instrumental searches, and then samples were taken after that. And the samples were of petrified wood, metal rivets, iron bars, and such like. And these have been laboratory tested and shown to be definitely man-made structure.
That's amazing. And of course, when we come back, we're going to discuss more about the actual scientific proof that this was, in all probability, the actual ancient Ark of Noah. We'll be back in just a moment with more remarkable information from ancient archaeologists. You need to get this ebook. Go to beforeus.com. We'll be back in just a moment.